Hey guys, and welcome back to the WT Farm Girl channel. I have an exciting series we are calling Teach a Farm Girl. So let's go and see what I'm gonna learn today. Hey guys, and welcome back to the Teach a Farm Girl series. Today we've got something quite different for you. We are going to go look at a dairy farm here in Michigan. They've got some amazing programs and might even get to see me milk a cow. Maybe. Let's check it out. Developing love early in life. Have you ever wondered exactly how milk comes from a cow? Sure, you know they get milked, but how does a cow get milked? How does milk travel from the cow into a truck or into your grocery store? Today, we're going to learn the three ways that Swiss Lane Farms here in Michigan uses to milk their cows.
Sanitizer solution going onto those brushes right now, so it's sanitizing the udder. When we first started, it was only going around one time on the udder, and we decided that we thought we could do better with milk quality and udder cleanliness, and so we wanted to go two rounds of sanitizer brushes. You can see the milk coming out.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
So how many gallons are you going to get from her today right now?
They'll probably do about 3 gallons per milking.
Oh, okay.
And they do about 3.2 milkings per day.
Wow.
So they're right around. Well, these two robots right here, the cows in these pens, are really high production. They like compete at the world level. So
really?
They're probably giving, I would say, about 5 gallons a day.
Wow.
I was doing our overall average. These cows are amazing right here.
So these are the stars right here.
They are the stars of the show, that's for sure. They can compete with anybody in the world. They're awesome. So
now,
very proud of them.
How long does it take to do each milking?
6 minutes.
Really?
So, yeah.
Wow.
So we have a parlor where we have people actually attaching the milker on the cow, and there is about 5 minutes per cow, so it only takes one extra minute for the technology or the robot to milk the cow than
the people. Oh, okay.
So the robot's pretty speedy, and the cows really like it. They know what to expect every single time they come in here. And yeah, cows are really creatures of habit. So when they have technology helping them, it gives them that consistency and they can just thrive. So instead of being out here milking the cows and putting the milkers on, we've got somebody here every day coming and checking all this technology and doing.
So you have to have a trained specialist overseeing everything.
Yeah, so they go through a whole maintenance training program to learn how to, it's like computer science stuff.
Right, oh yeah.
Animal science here, learning more about the computers.
So yeah. Now, this really raises your costs for production, though, doesn't it? Putting one of these machines in?
Well, you have a lot more upfront costs. So we still have to have people here milking the cow or taking care of the robot. So it's all in, we do get a little bit more production out of the cows and the robot because they aren't on our schedule. They're on their own schedule. It's more individualized and customized for each cow. Over time, it can be pretty comparable. It is a bigger upfront cost, though. The only thing that would have a potential of interrupting the cow's schedule is something going down on the robot. The longest we've gone without having the robot down is about 3 hours.
Oh,
and that's over
awesome.
An 8-year period.
Wow.
Parlor. This is where we milk 1,500 cows every day.
So this is by hand?
Yes, this is by hand. So
wait, you said you milk 1,500 cows?
Every day here, yes.
Wow.
We have 2,000 milking cows. So,
wait, 2,000?
Yes, because 1,500 here and 500 at the robot.
Oh, yes. Holy cow.
So these guys are on, they're on our schedule, where the robot farm, they were on their schedule. So they come in every 8 hours to get milk. Oh. So he's putting the lotion on, like you saw at the robot farm.
Oh, they
have to help keep them healthy.
Keep them moisturized. Yeah.
We don't want them to get infection while
Right. And
we want them to feel comfortable. So just like a woman breastfeeding.
Right, yeah. Where you put the lanolin cream on and Oh man, that stuff's a lifesaver.
So you can see their udders are all empty now and they're ready to go back to the free cell barn and
yeah.
Eat their food.
Oh? Where's this empty?
They're back there waiting in line. They can't wait till it's their turn.
Oh yeah.
A lot of their creatures of habit, Annie said before. So even a lot of times they try to fight for the same stuff.
So now what are they doing back here?
They're gonna go back to the freestall barn now.
So they all just line up?
Yeah, they're lined up and they're gonna head back to their barn. And then here comes the ladies coming in.
Oh my word.
Let's say hi.
You're like, hey guys.
So before they come in, they always get washed first because we want to make sure their udders are clean before we milk them. So he's going to put a soap on them and then wash them with a washcloth. Every cow gets its very own washcloth. So we milk 1,500 times, 3 times a day. So we have that many washcloths.
Wow.
And that much laundry.
So who gets stuck having to do the laundry?
Not me. I think all the guys at the parlor do laundry. So he washes them up and he's testing their milk too. We're always testing it to make sure it looks healthy. And
right.
Then it gets tested before it leaves the tank to go into the milk truck. And it also gets tested before it leaves the milk truck to get pasteurized. We want to make sure there's nothing in there that's unnatural.
Now do these guys get a little treat too while they're eating or no?
No, when they get back to the freestall barn, their food is in the water.
Oh, okay.
I know, those robot cows are spoiled, right? Kind of like my dog thinking he can only sit if he gets a treat.
Yeah. Why else would I want to?
So these numbers up here, those are their ear tag numbers. It registers when they come in automatically, and then the next number that will come up after he starts milking them will be how much milk they're giving us. So you can see it over here. She already gave us 22 pounds of milk.
Wow.
and then it just falls off when it's done.
So how does it,
when their udders are empty and it feels nothing coming through, it will fall right off.
Wow.
Yeah.
Just kind of ride it like a horse. That'd make a great video. She's a Swiss cow. So does she make chocolate?
She does not. You're gonna see. You get to find out what kind of milk she makes.
Yeah, she's a Swiss brown cow, so she must make Swiss brown chocolate milk to make chocolate with.
Yeah, no, it's not really how that works.
You saw it in the robot, hopefully, on the cow's udder after they're done milking. The robot will just spray it onto the udder. It's called their post dip. And what that does is just supposed to seal up their udder. And also it's like a soothing or like a moisturizer too.
Oh, okay.
So if you see the green, that means that they were milked.
Oh, okay.
So the robot must have got a little bit overboard and got some.
Just sprayed her really good.
It's really supposed to be on the four quarters. It's not supposed to be up here, but I mean, it's fine. It's just gonna, it's just a sealant and protecting and and moisturizing. So everybody needs that in the winter, right?
Oh yeah, for sure.
They have chapped udders and stuff.
No.
It's not okay. We're not going to go through the whole milking process. I really just want you to see if you know
just
how to
squeeze and release and
actually get the milk out of the udder. Like, we're not going to go through the full preparation. Like, you're not going to do the
sanitizing and the
sanitizing or anything like that. I'll be really impressed if you can actually get any milk out. I will be very, very proud. So I will have done my job.
Okay. I don't have a three-legged milking stool.
No. You are just gonna bend down because we use robots to milk the cows now. We don't really do this, so.
Okay.
You already know how?
Why? How do you know how to do this?
Way back when I was in sixth grade,
yep, definitely coming through.
Yeah, he said about an hour.
So yeah.
Yeah, she's got to push. Close up. She's
How
not
long
very
does
pretty.
It take to push the baby out?
Once you see the feet coming out, that's like active labor, and you want to get that calf out within like an hour to an hour and a half.
Oh, okay.
Ideally, she's supposed to do it on her own.
Right.
But if she's not making any progress, then we have Marcelino here, who, I mean, 24 hours a day, we've got these maternity pens under surveillance. They're like midwives. They come in and will help and assist with the delivery. So, yeah, she's getting ready to push hard.
Wow.
So, we should see. So, her bag of waters.
That's the bag water broke. So, now her udder is extremely large. Was that because she's like the baby's down there and is pushing anything downward?
No, her udder is just engorged. Okay. So, right, that's one of the signs of labor is that their udder will get engorged. Okay. And then they've got the mucusy show. They put their tail up. They put their tail up and they start pushing. And you also know their due date, too, because we do pregnancy confirmation with them and know when the last time they got bred was, and then we know when the baby's due. So we really keep a really close eye on her.
So how old is she? Is this her first calf?
This will be her first calf. Really? So she is probably about 2 years old, about 24 months. They'll have their first calf. And so today will be the first time that we get milk from her. So it's really exciting. So for 2 years, we just hope, pray, and invest, and
hope that you'll have a return.
That we'll get a really long life out of this cow, and she'll be able to produce and stay here for quite a few years, making milk, and then provide food through meat, too. Right. So the dairy cows are just amazing animals. I mean, they can produce milk for years and years, and then, I just saw feet.
What?
Yep, she pushed. Oh, look at that little foot. Oh, look. New life. She needs to lay down.
And there's randomly a baby over there. Surprise! Well,
we got one.